concept. So this is the most very important concept, and also so many bits are coming in this mensuration. At least 3 marks or 4 marks will be coming in this chapter. So don't waste our time. So let us start the mensuration concept. Okay, so 2-dimensional figures first of all we have to know, then after that 3-dimensional figures. What is this mensuration? Means 2-dimensional figures and 3-dimensional figures, if you want to know the study of the areas and perimeters and volumes, these are all coming under this mensuration. So the branch of mathematics which deals with 2-dimensional figures and 3-dimensional figures studies areas and perimeters and volumes, that is called mensuration. So this mensuration is having 2-dimensional figures and 3-dimensional figures. In this 2-dimensional figures, first of all we have to learn about triangle. So means you have to learn the formulas of all triangles, isn't it? So this is a equilateral triangle, we know very well. So equilateral triangle area you have to remember, that is A is equal to root 3 by 4 into A square. So that is a area of the equilateral triangle. If the general area, if you take the general area of the triangle is half into base into height. Half into base into height. So any triangle if you take, that is a half into base into height. If you know the height of the triangle, if you know the base of the triangle, so then you can use this formula, half into base into height. And perimeter is equal to the sum of the all sides of a triangle. The sum of the all sides of a triangle is called perimeter. So that is AB plus BC plus CA. So here perimeter is 3A. Perimeter is 3A. And also one more extra thing you have to learn, that is height of the equilateral triangle is root 3 by 2 into A. Root 3 by 2 into A. So these are the most very important formulas about triangle. Next we are going to discuss about quadrilaterals. Quadrilaterals, so area of the quadrilateral if they ask, means we have to learn. See here, this is a quadrilateral. So I am drawing the diagonal here. So from for this diagonal I am drawing the one perpendicular, that is H1, one more perpendicular I am drawing, that is H2. This is the diagonal D. Now area of this quadrilateral is nothing but A is equal to half into D into H1 plus H2. Half into D into H1 plus H2. This is the formula for area of the quadrilateral, area of the any quadrilateral. Next. So area of the rectangle, so length into breadth, length into breadth. So this is the length and this is the breadth. Area of the rectangle is length into breadth. And perimeter of the rectangle, 2 into L plus B, 2 into L plus B. Next, parallelogram. So in the parallelogram, if you draw a perpendicular, that is called H and this is called base, then area of the parallelogram is B into S, base into height, base into height. And area of the rhombus, rhombus we have diagonals, that is D1 and D2. So this is D1 and this is D2. So area of the rhombus is half into D1 D2, half into D1 D2. So this is the area of the rhombus, this is the area of the rectangle, area of the parallelogram, area of the quadrilateral. Now area of the square. So area of the square is side into side, that is A square, and perimeter of the square is A plus A plus A plus A, that is 4A. So this is the area of this square and area of the and also coming to rhombus, perimeter is nothing but 4A. This is also 4A because A. So these are the basic things we have to learn in 2-dimensional figures. And also one more thing is there, that is circle. Already we discussed. So area of the circle is pi r square and perimeter of the or circumference of the circle is 2πr. So these are all coming under this 2A, means 2D, 2-dimensional figure. Now we are going to discuss about 3-dimensional figure. So 3D. What is this 2-dimensional and 3-dimensional? 2-dimensional means the figures which we can't hold with hand. Those are called 2-dimensional figures. Means those can be represented on board. So the 3-dimensional figures means the figures which we can hold with hand, those are called 3-dimensional figures, which cannot be drawn on board. Just we are imagine, it is like this. So those are called 3-dimensional figures. 2-dimensional figures are having x-axis and y-axis, means it is having length and breadth, length and breadth. 3-dimensional figures are having x-axis and y-axis and z-axis, means it is having length, breadth and height. So length, breadth, height. See here, this is the length, this is the breadth, this is the height. So like this it will be there. In this three dimensional figures, first diagram is prism. What is this prism? If you know prism and if you know pyramid, if you know these two concepts, the whole formulas you need not to by heart, you can easily remember. So I am saying, using concept only we have to remember, we should not mug up or we should not by heart. So using concept only, if you remember, definitely it is very easy. So see here, concept prism, a three dimensional figure, which is having top and bottom, which is having top and bottom of the same polygon, and the lateral portions are parallelograms, then that is called, prism. A three-dimensional figure, see, I am drawing. A three-dimensional figure which is having top and bottom. Top and bottom are the same polygon. Top and bottom is same polygon, and lateral portion are parallelograms. Lateral portions are parallelogram. Then that is called prism. For example, if you want to draw a prism, you have to draw same polygons. Then after that, join. So this is called. If the name of the prism is nothing but depending upon the polygon only it is giving a name. This is triangular prism because triangle is there. This is a parallelogram prism. This is a square prism. This is the pentagonal prism. So like this we can say prism. If these are all, if you keep in the right angle, means if you are straight, in the straight way, then that is called right prism. That is called regular prism or right prism. We can say right prism. So for example, if I draw like this. This is a right triangular prism, So we are giving the formulas for right triangular prisms only, for right prisms only. Now you come to know what is this prisms like that. See here, one more thing I am drawing again. So this is a triangular prism. It is having how many faces? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 5 faces it is having. How many sides? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, sides or edges. We can say sides or edges. Is how many? So, 9 are there. So, we can say that faces general formula is bases plus, so here two faces na, so polygon bases number of polygon bases means here how many bases is there? 1, 2, 3. So number of the polygon bases plus 2. So here number of the polygon bases, how many? 3 plus 2, so total 5. So any polygon we can say. Sides, base into 3, number of the bases into 3. Here number of bases, how many? 1, 2, 3 into 3 means, so 3 is a 9. So like this general formula we can say. Now we have to discuss about, it is having two areas. One is lateral surface area and one is total surface area, and also it is having volume. So what is lateral surface area, what is total surface area, and what is volume, let us now discuss. So lateral surface area means the area which is covered by So the side portions of the figure, which is called, that is called lateral surface area. If this triangular prism, if you observe the lateral surface area, so this side portion and back side portion. So these three are called lateral surface area. How you will get lateral surface area? Let us see. Lateral surface area. Total surface area means top and bottom also, if you consider, that is total surface area, no lateral surface area. For your better understanding, I am explaining. Listen. For example, I am having a triangle, a small triangle. So, which is having only like a bangle. So, bangle circle is there. So, the bangle circle, same like that, I am taking triangle. So, triangular, I am taking. So, in the triangle, same triangle, I am keeping on this triangle. One more triangle I'm keeping, same bangle, 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 like that. So triangular bangle and triangular bangle, triangular. So like that I'm keeping, so that is coming up to this much. So this is called what? Prism, triangular prism. So how I got lateral surface area? These three sides so are covered with bangle. So that is nothing but perimeter of the triangle. So first of all, what I have taken? Perimeter of the triangles. The sum of the sides of a triangle is called perimeter, I told. So perimeter of the triangle. Again, I added one more perimeter. Again, perimeter. Again, perimeter. So like that, that perimeter is increased by up to how much? Some height, some extent height. So means what I have done, for getting lateral surface area, we have to do the perimeter of the base into height, perimeter of the base. I'm taking triangle, you take circle, you take square, you take rectangle, whatever you take. So that is the lateral surface area, nothing but perimeter of base into height. So this is the formula for everything. What we are learning in the menstruation, this is the basic formula. If you know this formula, you need not to by heart. Really, I'm saying, if you know this formula, you need not to by heart any formulas. Next, total surface area. So total surface area we want means this lateral surface area first we have to take, then after that base and height areas. So that is nothing but lateral surface area plus 2 into area of the base. 2 into area of the base. What are the base you take, that base area you have to take. So if it is circle, you have to take circle. If it is a triangle, you have to take triangle like that. Now volume. See, volume concept also I am going to explain. So volume means, see here now, the same triangle only I am taking. Now I am not taking bangle. So using some material or some plank. So I have a plank. I have cut the plank in the shape of triangle. So same another triangle also I kept. Another triangle like that I have kept like this. So then what happened here? So the inside is not there, but outside I am saying, so inside not there, that is only volume. Means a figure which is having highest capacity in it, so to fill anything, so that is called volume of the three-dimensional figure. So in this, volume means what I have taken, first of all, triangle. So total area of the triangle first I have taken. Again one more triangle. Like that I have got this much of height. So this is called volume of the figure. Now area of the base into height. What I have taken? Area of the base. First I have taken base area. That base area I increased up to some extent height. So area of the base into height. So then you will get the volume of the any figure. So these three formulas, remember, I am going to explain in the menstruation. Total formulas are very easy. So total formulas are very, very easy. So perimeter of the height in perimeter of the base into height and lateral surface area plus 2 into area of the base and area of the base into height. These three formulas are enough for us. So now first we are going to listen in the prism, that is called cylinder. First cylinder only we will learn in this concept. So our cylinder, before that one, cuboid. See here, cuboid I'm going to explain now. A cuboid means which is having length, breadth, height, then that is called cuboid figure. A three-dimensional figure which is having length, breadth, height, that is called cuboid. See, this is a length. This is the breadth, this is the height. So now, this cuboid is having how many faces? So how many faces this cuboid is having? 6 faces, already I have explained. So number of the base plus 2. So here number of the base, number of the sides of the base, how many? 4 plus 2, that is 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So faces, how many? 6 faces. How many vertices? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 faces. How many edges? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 faces. So here F plus V is equal to E plus 2. Remember, this is the Euler formula. So we can say this is the Euler formula. Euler formula we can say. So this is the Euler formula. F plus V is equal to E plus 2. So see, 6 plus 8 is equal to 14. 12 plus 2 is equal to 14. So most very important. So in the basic concepts also they are giving. So listen this one also. This is also remember this one. Now, we have to discuss about lateral surface area, total surface area and volume. So lateral surface area, what I explained, area of perimeter of the base into height. What is the perimeter here? 2 into L plus B, because it is a rectangle. 2 into L plus B. So perimeter of the base into height, so H. So enough, 2H into L plus B. So we need not to buy 2H into L plus B. That is the lateral surface area of a cuboid. Next, total surface area. So this is a lateral surface area, what? 2HL, 2HB. Still, we have to find area of the base and area of the top. These two have to add. 2 into LB, because area of the base is LB. So if you take out 2 common, then LB plus BH plus HL. So this is the concept. Next, volume. Volume what? Area of the base into height. So that is a general formula. Area of the base into height. Here area of the base what? L into B. Height what? H. So LBH. So this is the using cuboid we can easily learn these formulas. So easily we are remembering these formulas using concept. Next, cube. A cuboid in which all sides are equal, then that is called cube. A cuboid in which all sides are equal, then that is called cube. So that is A, we can say. Now, what are the values in your variable? Substitute everything is A, you will get the answer. I using basic concept. So basic concept also you will get. So perimeter of the base into height. Perimeter of the base what? Perimeter of the base 4A. Into height what? A. So 4A square. Or 2A into A plus A. 2A. 2A into 2A, 4A square. Next, total surface area. A square like that, 6A squares will be there. 6A squares will be there. Or down A square and up A square total. So 4A square plus 2A square, 6A square. Next, volume. What is the volume here? Base area of the base into height. Area of the base what? A square. Into A means A cube. Otherwise, A into A into A, A cube. So like this, we can know the cuboid formulas and cube formulas without by hearting. Now we are going to discuss about cylinder. So cylinder we are going to learn. Cylinder diagram, see here. The cylinder is having height H and radius R. No, lateral surface area. So what I told, perimeter of the base. Perimeter of the base what? 2 pi R, because circle. So base is nothing but circle. 2 pi R into H, perimeter of the base into height, height H. So that is 2 pi R H. Total surface area. So lateral surface area plus area of the base, 2 into area of the base. So area of the base what? Pi R square. So 2 into pi R square. So like this you can remember. So in this what is common? 2 pi R is common. So if you take out 2 pi R common, then H plus R, R R plus H. Next, volume. Don't by heart. So listen, this is the way to remember. What is the volume? Area of the base into height. Area of the base into height. What is the area of the base? Pi R square. Because circle into height H. So pi R square H. So no need of by hearting. So I'm forgetting. So don't say. So this is the easiest way to learn. So pi R square H. This is the formulas of cylinder and cylinder important things. Next. So next, after that we have to learn pyramid. Using pyramid concept you will get cone. So you will get cone. Okay, pyramid. So this is the quadrilateral I'm taking. Here, one point I'm taking. From this, one point I'm joining. So this is called pyramid, quadrilateral pyramid. So if I take square, square pyramid. This is a square pyramid. If I take triangle, this is a triangular pyramid. So means a three-dimensional figure which is having base any polygon and top is only one vertex. Top is only one vertex and side portions are triangles and side portions are triangles. Then that is called pyramid. Then that is called pyramid. So if the pyramid is in a straight way, means like this. So this is a right pyramid. For right pyramid only we are giving the formulas. For a pyramid also we have lateral surface area and total surface area and volume. So lateral surface area is nothing but half into pyramid of the base into slant height. Slant height. And total surface is nothing but lateral surface area. Plus here only we have to add base, only one base. Whereas coming to in the prism we are having 2 into area of the base, but here only one area of the base. So area of the base and volume. So here see here 1 by 3 it is reduced. So as compared to prism, so 1 by 3 into area of the base into height, area of the base into height. So these are the three important formulas for remembering the pyramid formulas. Next, we have to learn about cone. So cone is, this is the cone, this is the height, this is the radius, this is the slant height L. So if you observe this three R clearly, then you know very well, so L square is equal to H square plus R square because it is a satisfying Pythagoras theorem. So Pythagoras theorem is satisfying. So L square is equal to H square plus R square. So L is equal to root over H square plus R square. So by knowing any two values in this equation, we know we can come to know the third value. We can come to know the third value. Now lateral surface area. So that is pi R L. So remember pi R L. Total surface area, that is pi r l plus 1 a, what is the area of the base? Pi r square. So take out common pi r, then you will get pi r into r plus l or l plus r. And volume, so volume is 1 by 3, area of the base what? Pi r square. And h what? Height what? H. So 1 by 3 pi r square h. So using the same radius and same height of the cone, if you pour this water into the cylinder, three times if you pour, the cylinder will be fill up. So like that we can easily come to know. Next, sphere. So next is sphere. In a space, the set of points, the set of all points in a space which are equidistant from the fixed point. So same as circle, but circle is in two dimensional and sphere is three dimensional. So in a plane, the set of all points which are equidistant from the fixed point is called circle. In a space, the set of all points which are equidistant from the fixed point is called sphere. This is sphere. So sphere, lateral surface area is equal to total surface area, both are equal. So that is nothing bad. So if you made this sphere using thread, if you made this total covered and cut the last one, then open the thread in a straight line, then make the thread into four equal parts, then find the each thread area that is using like circle, then you can find the total surface area, lateral surface area of this sphere, that is 4 pi r square, because we are having 4 circles, so 4 pi r square. So if you may, then you will get, so 4 circles, equal circles. So the area of this 4 circles is nothing but area of the sphere, that is only lateral surface area, that is only total surface area. Next, volume. So volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube, 4 by 3 pi r cube, that is the volume of the sphere. So if I make cut equally, so means in the, it is a circle which is dividing the sphere into two equal parts, then that is called hemisphere, not semisphere, that is hemisphere. So hemisphere is like bowl we are using in a home. So it is also having lateral surface area, half means 2 pi r square. Whereas coming to total surface area, it is having 3 pi r square, because this is also one circle. So circle area is pi r square. So 2 pi r square plus pi r square means 3 pi r square. Whereas volume 4 by 3, not, that is 2 by 3 pi r cube. 2 by 3 pi r cube. So like this, we can easily remember this formula. And tomorrow, we are having problems, top 15 models problems. In this top 15 models, we are having so many shortcuts, because using shortcuts only we can find the solutions of this one. Otherwise, it is a long process. So long process means time taking process. These are all time taking problems. So this all time taking problems, how to do in an easy way. So tomorrow we will see the class. So thank you very much for watching our smart channel. If you like this video, you just like it. And if you want to make your friends join in our groups, let them join. So please share my group links to all members, all your friends, all WhatsApp numbers. And so thank you very much. Bye bye.